Good morning, children. Today we will do the new chapter, that is biotechnology principles and processes. Now, what is biotechnology? Biotechnology, it is the process of using living organisms or their enzymes, to obtain products or to develop processes useful for the human beings. For example, any living organism is used. Let me give you one common example from your daily life. For example, the yeast. Yeast, it is used in fermentation, it is used in baking, some bacteria are used in curd making. So all these processes, all they come under biotechnology. Now, biotechnology, it has been practiced by humans since a very, very long time. And this baking, brewing, curd making, it is not the new concept. It has been, the organisms have been doing over a long time. And here in these processes, the microbes are used to obtain products for human welfare. Or we can say that the uses of microorganisms in the welfare of mankind. This is what is there. So, now, according to the European Federation of Biotechnology, that is EFB, the integration of natural science and organism cell parts and molecular analogies for product and services. And who is the father of biotechnology? Paul Berg. Paul Berg, remember it, sometimes one mark questions come from it, that who is the father of biotechnology? It is Paul Berg. And the term biotechnology was given by Carl Ehrlich. Again, this is important, you should know. And biotechnology, children, it has got two aspects. Which are they? One is the traditional or the old concept of biotechnology aspect, and second is the modern or the molecular aspect of biotechnology. Now, in the traditional, what is there? Here, the process is based on the natural capability of the microbes. What the microbes are doing on their natural way, suppose they are breathing, they are respiring, it is their natural process. We are not doing any artificial thing in this. So, using microbes or enzymes for obtaining products, that comes under the traditional aspect of biotechnology. For example, fermentation, baking, curd making, cheese making, etc. And what is there in the modern molecular aspect of biotechnology? Here, the organisms are genetically modified. Genetically modified or genetically manipulated. What do we mean by this? In Hindi, we can say that uske genetic material se chhedchhad ki jati hai. Uske genetic material ko change kiya jata hai, manipulate kiya jata hai. That is called as the modifying the organisms genetically. And then whatever the products are produced, they are used by the human beings. And it has two again aspects. One is the genetic engineering. Again, genetic engineering, we are using different tools in the genetic engineering. We will study one by the one, in which the various organisms are altered. Followed? And second is the maintenance of the sterile conditions during chemical engineering processes. Sterile conditions are maintained. Followed? So, example is using recombinant DNA technology to obtain pest-resistant plants, vaccines, etc. What the farmers require? They want that their crops, they should not be destroyed by the pests. So scientists, they are trying to develop the varieties that are resistant to pests. And how it can be possible? It is possible by using the R or the recombinant DNA technology. Now how it is done, children, we will do in the next chapter, that is the applications of biotechnology. We will do the whole processes. Then again, the development of vaccines. What is vaccine? Again, it is the where the microbes of the particular disease, they are weakened or sometimes they are made dead. Then they are introduced into the body, and when they are introduced, they act as the antigens and produce the antibodies to protect our body from further infections. So this is now let us see the first recombinant DNA technology. How was it? Just listen to me and look carefully. Now, First recombinant DNA was produced by Cohen and Boyer in 1972. Remember, sometimes the question comes, who formed the first recombinant DNA? It was Cohen and Boyer in 1972 by adding antibiotic resistant gene of Salmonella typhimurium. Now, Salmonella typhimurium, it is a bacteria. What is it? It is a bacteria. And it lives in the gut of the organisms, human beings. And this antibiotic resistant gene, it is transferred to the plasmid of the E. coli, Escherichia coli. Let us see from the diagram. Now children, here you can see the plasmid of the Salmonella typhimurium. This yellow color depicts the antibiotic resistant gene. Now some enzymes which are called as the endonucleases which helps to break down the genetic material. They make a cut over here and this gene is isolated. This antibiotic resistant gene of yellow color, it is isolated. Then another plasmid of E. coli, another bacteria, it is taken. Again it is cut. Here it is made a little bit straighter. And what happens? This gene, with the help of the ligase enzyme, it is introduced into this plasmid of the E. coli. Now this DNA, or you can say, or the plasmid of the E. coli with this antibiotic resistant gene from this bacteria, this is called as a recombinant DNA. What is it called? Recombinant DNA. And now this plasmid, it is transformed in the E. coli. So it is called as a genetically modified organism. Have you followed? Now here, the earlier it was this plasmid only of purple color. Now there is a gene of yellow color introduced in it. Now it is known as a transformed E. coli, or we can say that they are the genetically modified organisms, or the GMOs. Followed, children? Now, in the next page, I will show you the recombinant DNA, rDNA technology, or genetic engineering. It is also called rDNA technology, or we can also call it genetic engineering, or we can say it gene manipulation. In Hindi we can say that genes ke uske genetic material ke saath chhedchhad kar li. Theek hai? So what is it? It is a process by which DNA of specific organisms can be isolated and can be added to DNA of other organisms at a desired location to obtain specific gene product. Jaise maine aapko peeche example mein samjhaya hai. Same. So now there are three basic steps in genetically modifying an organism. Agar humne kisi organism ko genetically modify karna hai, to humne teen steps follow karne hai. Kya kya hai? Number one, identification of DNA with the desired genes. Sabse pehle to we should know ki which are the desired genes in which organism. Wo genes kaun si hain jo jinka hame fayda hai, jinko humne use karna hai apne fayde ke liye. ठीक है, उनको आइडेंटिफाई करना है. नंबर टू, इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द डिजायर्ड डीएनए सेगमेंट इनटू द सूटेबल होस्ट. जैसे हमने ई कोलाई में एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंट जीन को इंट्रोड्यूस किया है, फिर हमने डिजायर्ड डीएनए सेगमेंट को, पोर्शन ऑफ डीएनए इज कॉल्ड एज अ जीन, सो फिर इसको सूटेबल होस्ट में ट्रांसफ़र कर देना है. फिर क्या करना है? मेंटेनेंस ऑफ इंट्रोड्यूस डीएनए इन द होस्ट एंड ट्रांसफ़र ऑफ डीएनए टू द प्रोजेनी. फिर उस होस्ट को हमने रिप्रोड्यूस करवाना है, उसको मल्टीप्लाई करना है, सो दैट वी कैन गेट मल्टीपल कॉपीज ऑफ दैट रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए. तो उसको ज़्यादा मल्टीपल कॉपीज होंगी, देन ओनली वी कैन यूज़ इट ऑन द कमर्शियल स्केल. नाउ दिस इज द थ्री बेसिक स्टेप्स. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, वी विल डू द टूल्स. There are mainly three tools of the genetic engineering. Tools क्या होते हैं हिंदी में, क्या बोलते हैं? जो कोई जैसे कोई मिस्त्री है, वो अपने तीन tools use करता है. ठीक है, जिनके जैसे कोई tailor है, वो क्या use करेगा? कि machine, sewing machine use करेगा. ठीक है, एक उसके पास scissors होंगी, number two, three उसके पास thread होगा, तभी वो किसी चीज़ की stitching कर पाएगा ना. Followed. Similarly, अगर हमने genetic engineering करनी है, तो हमें भी ऐसे ही कुछ tools चाहिए जिनसे हम कर सकते हैं वो क्या क्या हैं. नंबर वन इट इज़ द एंजाइम्स, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नंबर टू इट इज़ द वेक्टर्स और दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज द क्लोनिंग वेक्टर्स. नंबर थ्री इट इज़ द कॉम्पिटेंट होस्ट. नाउ इफ यू सी द एंजाइम चिल्ड्रन कमिंग टू द फर्स्ट टूल ऑफ जेनेटिक इंजीनियरिंग दैट इज द एंजाइम्स. आई पुट इट इन अ बॉक्स. लाइजिंग एंजाइम्स, लाइजिंग मीन्स ब्रेक डाउन, जो सेल को ब्रेक डाउन कर दें. दे आर यूज टू लाइज द सेल सो दैट द डीएनए कैन बी सेपरेटेड. सो हमें ऐसी एंजाइम्स चाहिए जो सेल को ब्रेक डाउन कर दें और उससे हम डीएनए निकाल लें. एंड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन विच सेल हैज़ टू बी लाइज्ड डिफरेंट लाइटिक एंजाइम्स आर यूज. नाउ फॉर एनिमल सेल, यू नो एनिमल सेल इट हैज़ गॉट द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. एंड प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन चिल्ड्रन इन एनिमल सेल इट इज़ मेड अप ऑफ प्रोटीन्स एंड लिपिड्स. सो वट इज रिक्वायर्ड हेयर द एंजाइम्स आर प्रोटीएजेस एंड द लाइपेजेस. सिमिलरली फॉर प्लांट सेल वी हैव गॉट द सेलुलोज इन द सेल वॉल, पैक्टिन इज देयर एंड अगेन द प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन इज देयर. फॉर सेलुलोज सेलुलेज पैक्टिन इज फॉर पैक्टिन. देन फॉर फंगल सेल, यू नो सेल वॉल ऑफ फंगस इज मेड अप ऑफ काइटिन. सो टू ब्रेक द काइटिन वॉल वी रिक्वायर द एंजाइम काइटिनेज एंड देन द प्रोटीएज एंड द लाइपेज. देन फॉर द बैक्टीरियल सेल देर इज एंजाइम कॉल्ड एज लाइजोजाइम विच कैन हेल्प टू ब्रेक द बैक्टीरियल सेल वॉल सो दैट द डीएनए कैन बी सेपरेटेड. देन नेक्स्ट इज चिल्ड्रन दीज आर द लाइजिंग एंजाइम्स. नंबर टू कैटेगरी कम्स द रिस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम्स. दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू शुड नो इट वॉट आर रिस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम्स. अर्लियर वी हैव सीन दैट द एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंट एंजाइम फ्रॉम द प्लाज्मिड ऑफ द सेल्मोनेला टाइफीम्यूरियम दैट वॉज सेपरेटेड बाय द एंजाइम एंडोन्यूक्लियोसिस. एंडोन्यूक्लियोसिस इज नथिंग एल्स बट इट इज़ अ रिस्ट्रिक्शन एंजाइम. फॉलोड. सो नाउ इन 1963 स्टुअर्ट लेन एंड वर्नर आर्बन आइसोलेटेड टू एंजाइम्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रिस्ट्रिक्टिंग द ग्रोथ ऑफ फेजेस इन ईकोला. नाउ वट आर फेजेस चिल्ड्रन. फेजेस, फेजेस आर नथिंग एल्स बट दे आर द वायरसेस. दे आर द वायरसेस दैट इन्फेक्ट ई कोलाई बैक्टीरिया. सो वट इज देयर वी हैव टू, वट द बैक्टीरिया हैज़ टू डू, इट हैज़ टू जनरेट और प्रोड्यूस सर्टन एंजाइम्स दैट विल रिस्ट्रिक्ट और प्रोहिबिट द ग्रोथ ऑफ द वायरसेस. फॉलो. देन नाउ वन ऑफ द एंजाइम added methyl group to the self DNA. Now suppose the bacteria is there. I will draw a simple diagram. Here it is the genetic material of the bacteria. What happens here? Here this bacteria, it will, you can say, produce the enzyme called methylase. Methylase enzyme is there. It will, this enzyme, it will add the methyl group, CH3, methyl group to the genetic material, to the self DNA. Followed. And when this methyl group is added, it is called as a methylated DNA. Now what is the role of it? It helps in protecting the self DNA from the restriction nuclease. Again, the first enzyme is methylase produced by the bacteria. Second enzyme which is produced by this bacteria, it is the nuclease. Now what is the role of this nuclease? It is the other enzyme, it cleaved means break down the unmethylated DNA and was called restriction nucleases. तो restriction nucleases का काम क्या है? जिस DNA के साथ methyl group नहीं attached होता, unmethylated होता है, वो उसको break down कर देता है. अब इसने अपने host के साथ तो methyl group लगा लिया, तो इसने अपने DNA को तो safe कर लिया. अब जब viral DNA यहाँ पे आएगा, समझ आ गया? Phage, कोई भी phage यहाँ पे enter करेगा, वायरल फेज, तो उसका जो डीएनए होगा उसको ये जो एंडोन्यूक्लियस है एंजाइम, फॉलोड, तो ये क्या करेगी? उसको डीएनए को ब्रेक डाउन कर देगी. सो इट विल प्रोटेक्ट इटसेल्फ फ्रॉम द एंडोन्यूक्लियसेस. फॉलोड. सो दिस इज यूज्ड टू बाय ईकोलाई टू कट फॉरेन डीएनए एंड प्रोटेक्टिंग इटसेल्फ. नाउ रिस्ट्रिक्शन एंडोन्यूक्लियसेस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ मॉलिकुलर सीजर्स. The common name, time and time, again and again, when we will do the chapter in a detail, we will have two chapters on biotechnology, this word molecular seizures will come. Now, Smith, Willcox and Kelley, they first isolated restriction enzyme from the bacteria Haemophilus influenzae and named it as a HIND2. In the next topic, we will do how to name these restriction enzymes. First isolated enzyme restriction was Haemophilus influenzae or HIND2. Now, HIND2 always cuts DNA molecule at a particular point by recognizing a sequence of 6 base pairs. Now, see the 6 base pairs. It is G, T, C or T, A, A, C. Complementary are there on the opposite strand of DNA. This we have done in the previous chapter. So, complementary strands are there. So, wherever this 6 base pair sequence is there, only there the HIND2 will act. If this sequence is missing, then it will not act. So, there are particular restriction enzymes. So many restriction endonucleases are there that will act on the particular segment of the DNA. Now, HIND2 always cuts between third and fourth base pair of this segment. Third and fourth base pair, it is here. It will cut over here at this point. Followed? And now we have, till date, we have got 900 restriction enzymes isolated from over 230 strains of bacteria. Now, this restriction enzymes, they belong to the category called as the nucleases, commonly called as, and there are of two types, exonucleases, they break the terminal bonds of DNA, and number two is the endonucleases, they break the internal bonds of DNA. Now, children, again, we will do the next point, that the restriction endonucleases